reaches that threshold, someone from the Trump White House is supposed to respond to. Now, number one, Donald Trump is not going to be sitting there personally browsing around on his laptop or whatever and responding to these petitions. That's not going to happen. In a best-case scenario, and this happens every single time I saw it, you're going to have some intern probably hate his or her life, hates his job, going to go there, look at it, and type up a very short, one-sentence response that's going to say, thanks for the signatures, but we disagree with your argument. Have a nice day. After all that work, that's the best that can possibly happen. Keep that in mind. Petitions themselves, as I said, are a very useful asset for backing up a claim that they cannot, should not, be used as the only way of backing up an argument. It would be a good way to use that to reinforce the argument that funding should be maintained for these radio stations. And you can say, also because we have a petition of et cetera individuals who feel very passionately the same. But it's not to say, look, we have a petition with this many signatures, that's why you should change your mind, because you're not going to simply at that. If you want to save WWV, WWVB or WWVH radio stations, number one, wait. You're going to have to wait. The reason why I say that is before anything else, before contacting the politicians, the representatives, and especially the members of this board that are specifically going to be deciding the budget for these stations, wait until Election Day is over. Because right now these politicians only care about getting reelected, and that's it. If you try and talk to them about the budget and this and that, it's going to go in one ear and out the other, because right now they're focused on getting reelected to their Senate seat, their House position, whatever it is. And let's just say the way things are looking this year, on both sides, some politicians are going to really be biting their fingernails off when it comes down to the possibility of getting reelected or not. So number one, wait until Election Day has come and gone. And then, you can do another petition, spread the word, advertise this thing to no end, get the word out about it, and most importantly, instead of telling people to only go ahead and sign this petition, write these congressmen, write these senators, write these House members with concise but readable arguments for why these stations should be on the air. Don't try to use terminology that's extremely technical or anything, because these people have very busy lives and schedules. Just say it in a concise, readable, and logical manner, and you never know. If enough people go ahead to them and contact them directly, eventually it will get ingrained into their head. Up to 100,000 emails, letters, phone calls, meetings with certain politicians will be far more impactful than just a piece of paper with 100,000 signatures on it. That I can tell you. And I will find them if they can run from 2,000 afterwards to standards of 1,000 letters. I was in contact with one of their representatives, and I asked them, I was talking to her about this potential project, and she was saying, you know, we really don't know what the future lies for this. And of course, the administration wants the National Institute of Standards and Technology budget severely and have all these stations off the air. But at the same time, it has also been proposed to increase our budget, which in that case is radio stations will remain on the air. In short, you just don't know what the future holds, but when it comes down to the growth of petitions, make them, use them, utilize them, but do not rely exclusively on them. Instead, individual and collective action in regards to actually contacting these lawmakers will be far more impactful, and a petition will be very useful in backing up the argument. That's all that I have. I'm off my soapbox. I want to talk to people with your comments, your views, opinions, or reception reports on this lecture. Send me an email if you're listening, borwinfo@gmail.com. That's the only way I have of knowing that anyone is listening to this broadcast. borwinfo@gmail.com. Once again, borwinfo@gmail.com. borwinfo@gmail.com. Need to hear from you. Let me know what you think. And with that, let's get on to some music. This is BORW. Thank you.